Alrighty guys, it's the Almighty D, you know, your man Garagon, and today we have a review of the PlayStation Gold Wireless Stereo Headset. Say that 10 times fast. Or something. Let's just get to the review. Alrighty guys, the PlayStation Gold Wireless Headset, it's a sleek thing. It makes me feel spiffy. I feel like I'm from the future. I feel like I'm from Jet Grind Radio, Jet Set Radio Future, with those giant ass headphones on my head. It makes me feel great. I feel like I'm a supermodel wearing this headset, man. I feel like I'm king of the world, you know? That's what I'm saying, you know? Sony, they know what they're doing with this. They know what they're doing. At least I hope they know what they're doing. Alrighty guys, this is the PlayStation 4/3/Vita Gold Wireless Headset Stereo, whatever thingamajig. And as you see right here, it is wireless, like I said, just like in the title. Now it fits right on your head comfortably. It has volume keys right here. They work very well. The buttons feel nice and smooth. I don't know why it won't focus, but there you go. Look at that. It also has a button VSS, which is virtual surround sound. So say somebody shooting a gun in back of you, you will hear basically the gunshots from in back of you or the explosions. It works quite well, and I think it's quite effective for how much it costs. I got this for $75 on Newegg, and I can't complain. It also has a mute button right here, just in case you're online and video games, and you just want to mute yourself. You don't want people hearing you scream or rage. I don't know why it won't focus, but it should. There you go. And it also has a mini USB, or is it micro? I don't even know. I'm pretty sure it might be mini. And then it also has the auxiliary cable. I believe that's what it's called, in which you could plug it, actually, so it's not wireless and you don't need to charge it. Then you have a button that goes 1, 2, and off. Now, 1 is preset. It will turn on when you put it on 1. And it should glow, as you see right there. 2 is another mode in which you download a certain type of sound mode from your PS4, and you could actually have game specific audio from the developers themselves, the settings they prefer for the game. So it is a nice feature to have, and it is great. Then you also have where you could basically manage the sound and then the chat as well. So if you want the sound of the game louder, you push up. If you want the chat louder, you push down. And it's that simple. It also has a microphone, but the microphone is basically non-existent in terms of physicality form, or whatever you would like to say, you know, because, you know, I'm great with my words. And basically it's a small hole on it, and it will hear your entire room. It's not the best quality, but it gets the job done. It makes it not in the way, and people can hear you quite clear, from at least in my experience. Now, I think it's comfortable. It's kind of flimsy. You could fold it like this. But along with that, it feels nice on the head. You could play for extended hours without feeling crazy, losing your mind. And I think overall, for $100, definitely worth it. I'm not no audiophile, but I can like tell the distinct difference between normal headphones and stuff such as this. Now, I'm not going to say it's the best headset in the world, but it is a great headset in my opinion. Now I'm going to show you what I was talking about with the audio profiles. Alrighty guys, first things first, you're going to want to make sure you have all your plugs unplugged. Basically, you need a lot of room for this stereo headset. First, you need to plug in the dongle in which your PS4 had came with, which I don't know where I've... Okay, I found it. You would plug it in the front. You need this, and it does come with it, so don't worry about that. And you're going to have it plugged in. It should glow at least sooner or later, at least when you activate your PS4. And also, you're going to need this mini USB wire cable that it comes with to change the audio settings profile. Then, you're going to head on over to the Headset Companion app, as you see right here. Open it up, and it will load up. It's free on the PlayStation Store. You're going to choose your headset, the gold wireless one we have, not the Pulse. I believe that's called the Pulse. And you're going to click it. Now, you're going to want to download a sound profile that it comes with. So, you could actually set it to default. This is how you also update your headset, so don't worry about that. It will teach you how. And basically, it's going to set it to your number 2, as you see right there. Now, what you do is you plug in this cable into your PS4, right? Like so. Then you're going to grab your headset wherever you had put it, which, okay, I found it. And you're going to plug it in right like so. So you're going to plug it in, make sure it's on, like that. And then put it right by your PS4. Should be somewhere right there, plugged in. And then you're going to choose a sound profile that you want. So for this, I guess I'm going to pick Destiny. And then I'm going to click upload. Now it says upload complete, unplug your headset, and enjoy the new sound preset. So you unplug it, and then there you go. As you see right there, that's all it takes. Now, as you see, the dongle is also glowing, and once you turn it on, it just say it is connected to your PS4, like so. As you see, now it shows my headset is plugged in, and that's basically how you set it up. Now you have your wireless headset on, as you see like this, and you've seen the actual notification in which it prompts. Alrighty guys, if you want to see how loud this headset can get, well, I'm going to show you right now. I'm going to put it around my neck like so, and I'm going to start up Hotline Miami. Now, it's not the loudest headset in the world in which people from other rooms could hear it emanating from it, but it does the job, and I think it actually does get the bass quite good. You could also disable the bass. I don't know if I mentioned that. I might have missed a button. Well, the bass is more or less in the virtual surround sound from what I remember. I'm mixing up stuff, but you're going to see how loud it can get, and it gets quite good. I think the audio quality is really good. Okay, right now it's emanating from my TV. I don't know why. Let me adjust devices, and I'm going to put all audio. Now, I'm pretty sure you hear that. I think it's pretty loud, and it actually sounds really good on your head. And I can't even hear myself. So I hope you guys enjoyed this review. I very much enjoyed doing it, and I very much enjoyed this headset, and I think it's definitely worth the money I've spent on it. Well, the money I've gotten from my birthday to spend on it. Because it was a birthday gift. And I don't know why I'm sweating. It's kind of hot. But anyway, this is me, the Almighty D. Hopefully you enjoyed this review for the gold wireless stereo headset. I gotta make sure I'm pointing out the correct stuff. But that's what you know. You know what I'm talking about. Now this is what it all includes. Like I said, it works with the Vita, the PlayStation 3, and the PlayStation 4. You can't go wrong, and you also can use it on your phone, but I really don't suggest bringing this out. I don't know. That's all I really have to say.